Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, it's a hard job to fill Brandon's shoes. I mean, he does a lot. He's a special player on the field. So we just, in the receiver room, we're just trying to, you know, it's always the next man up during these situations. So we're just trying to stay prepared and stay ready to go just in case our number's called. And then as far as the COVID situation, it kind of sucks right now because we're losing a lot of teammates. And it's happening every day. But, I mean, this is something we knew that was possible going into the season. And it's something that the whole league is dealing with. So we're just going to continue to battle through it.
Brooks?
You know, so how are you personally approaching this in the next couple of days here? You kind of hunkering down? I mean, what's the way to kind of protect yourself here going into the game?
Yeah, I mean, they're doing a good job of we're doing a lot of meetings from Zoom and stuff. We're really only in contact during practice. So, I mean, for the most part, I'm just trying to stay hide away in my house and stay safe during practice. I'm wearing a little gator thing. I'm just doing whatever I can so I can be available for the team on Sunday.
Brandon?
Hey, Chris, you were a part of that 98-yard return that Trayvon had on Sunday. Could you just take us through it from your perspective, just what you saw, why that play worked, and also, were you surprised at how he was able to withstand the contact and also that he didn't trip over your feet after he stayed up on that return?
Yeah, I mean, Trayvon, he did a good job on the return. We had it set up nicely. A couple of their kickoff guys got out of coverage, but he hit the right hole he was supposed to, and he hit it strong. So, it was amazing to see him break through them tackles. And that's exactly what I was thinking when he broke through. I was like, man, please don't let him trip over me right here because that would be embarrassing. So I was just doing whatever I could at that point to get out of the way and escort him on the way to the end zone. But, I mean, he's capable of making plays like that all the time, and it was just good to see him do it.
Cody?
Hey, Chris. Earlier in the year, you know, you had one of your best performances in a game against the New England Patriots. You know, you and Davis Mills seemed like you guys had a lot of great connection. So, you know, with Brandon Cooks coming up, you one of the guys that's going to be filling in. Can you just talk about your relationship and your chemistry with Davis Mills as of right now?
Yeah, I mean, it always goes back to training camp, especially for me and him, because at that time, I believe Tyrod was getting a lot of ones reps, so that means Davis was getting the twos, and I was usually going with the twos with him. So we had the chemistry from then, and I feel like that's the most important thing when it comes to, like, the season. You get a lot of the stuff that's how you get prepared for these situations during training camp, because you never know who's going to be in, so you just got to get used to everybody, and I feel like that time we had together during training camp has really helped.
Brooks? All right, I think we're all set.
Awesome.
Man, nobody's got their cameras on.
Mark, you're on mute.
Oh, thanks, Brooks.
Mark, can you hear us?
All right, we'll go to Brooks while he's figuring that. Oh.
Yeah. You mentioned just. I'm curious how are you handling your time here preparing for the game? And I mean, are you hunkered down? I mean, how do you approach this? Just trying to stay safe and ready for the game.
My preparation throughout the week stays the same, whether it's virtual or not. It's just a little bit different watching it on an iPad than actually being able to watch film in the facility on the monitor with the clicker in my hand. But no, the way I'm going to approach it is the same as I approach my other three starts and how I approach playing in college too, and making sure I watch all the certain third down packages, short yardage, goal line, and doing my own scouting report. So stays the status quo. It's just things that, you know, this is where we're at and we have to do it on virtual, but it is what it is and we got to make sure that we can play on Sunday. So,
and you filled in before the season of different circumstances, obviously, but what have you learned in the time since for this next next chance you have here on Sunday?
A lot of things are more technical that I've learned probably. I got comfortable once the third game, you know, really came around with the playbook really. So I have been with the team for longer than a couple weeks now and I feel confident out there and my relationship with all the guys on the offense has been great so far. And really the things that I key takeaways from those games were like little technique things that I need to tweak a little bit that got me beat a couple times when I was playing.
Thanks.
Aaron.
Hey, Jimmy. As far as the guys in the locker room and just kind of dealing with it all, they've said that right now they're not having discussions about a postponement. How do you guys approach this in terms of the uncertainty of, you know, does the game get changed or do you just kind of hunker down and say, hey, you know, it's probably going to be Sunday and that's what we have to expect and it's going to be the guys that we have, not anyone possibly being activated?
Yeah, we haven't approached it that way either, that there's a possibility of postponement. We just – Coach Campen, right before practice, was like, hey, look around. This is the eight guys we got, and this is the eight guys we're going into the game with. So we're preparing to play on Sunday and, you know, just hoping that we get there and are able to compete.
Thank you.
Brandon?
Jimmy, I know that Justin was just put on the list What kind of resource is he to you? And you mentioned Campen as well and the relationships with some of the other guys on the offense. I wanted to ask specifically about Justin and then, you know, any other relationships on the offense that have just been helpful to you since you've been here.
Justin's been great. We have a really good relationship. He's one of my closest friends on the team probably. And he's an awesome veteran to learn from, really experienced player. And, you know, even while we're watching Zoom and Coach Kelly and Coach Campen are going through the film, he's sending me chats on the side like, hey, do this or, you know, on this screen, look out for that and just helped me along the way. And Justin's been, you know, the veteran teammate that you play behind. He's like the perfect example of like who you hope he is. So he's been great. And Coach Campen, too, has been awesome, former center in the NFL. And, you know, they've both been really valuable resources and helped me, you know, get ready to play.
Cool.
Jimmy, you look at yourself as a rookie and you also look at Davis. You've worked with him in practice before. Just overall in the past several games since he's been the starting role, what have you seen from his growth and development thus far?
Davis is a great player. There's a reason why they drafted him that high here and how he's been, you know, progressing every week, like you said. But he's, you know, I don't really look at it from like being a center on the team, like watching Davis. I mean, like, oh, you know, he's been better here and here this week and needs to be better here, blah, blah, blah. But Davis is a great teammate. He's a professional, even though he is a rookie, he handles his business day in and day out. And he's confident in the huddle and I like playing with him. So I'm excited to go out there on Sunday with him.
All right. Well, all set. Thanks, Jimmy.
Thanks, guys.
The secondary there, how have you guys, how did y'all approach it out there, practice today and just with the guys you had out there and what were you guys told?
Just next man up. Just got to go out there and next guy got to just fill in and it can't be no loops in it. Just got to go out there and do your job. And that's what we did. And then we got done with practice and finished on a high level.
Mark?
Tavierre, can you hear me okay?
Yes.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, Tremont said that he's giving all the guys who helped him score that touchdown a gift. He said he's getting some outrageous, expensive suggestions. What do you think about all that?
I would like some real, real nice, but hopefully when all this COVID stuff over with, we can go out to dinner or something, a nice dinner, steakhouse, Steak 48.
Did you tell him that?
Yeah, all right. I told him I want a steak. I want a big steak because I don't think he's going to spend too much money, but hopefully he takes us to a nice steakhouse. That's something I would give. I scored a touchdown, so hopefully he do that with us. Or something better.
Okay.
Something better would be fine.
Tavierre, last week was one of your better games of the season. You played the most significant amount of reps. What do you feel the most comfortable in your role right now, and where have you seen your biggest growth over the last several weeks?
Right. I'm just really just going out there, just doing my job, and Coach Lovey and the coaching staff just put me in position. My way, I just got to make them, just because I know if I don't make them, he's going to be on me. So that's, and it's Lovey, so I just listen to him, and he put me in position to make plays. So I just go out there and just try to make them. Hopefully I can make some this week.
Brooks.
And tell us about some of the guys that are stepping up. With the guys that are out, guys filling in. What do you see in the people who are replacing them on Sunday, and what their abilities are?
Okay. Well, I feel the same. Like if they're stepping in, they've been there for a while. Like Tremont, Jimmy, T. Mitch might be back. You never know. Hopefully he is. But I feel good. I feel good about the guys that are going to be out there. We just got to go out there and do our job and make plays when the plays come to us. And if we can do that, then we'll be potential to get the win.
And how are you approaching the next couple of days? Are you hunkered down here? I mean, what's the way to kind of protect yourself?
I'm at home with my mask on, so just got to keep that mask on and stay healthy. Just stay 6 feet apart from people at practice and stuff. Just get out there and practice. Do all our Zoom stuff, get out there and practice, get home. I'm just trying to get in and get out. So, yeah. I gotta play this one. I'm ready. I'm looking forward to playing Keenan. I'm really looking forward to that.
Last one for Brandon.
Tavierre, we may have asked you about this at some point in the season, but you mentioned Lovey earlier. I'm just curious, what do you like or appreciate most about Lovey's coaching style and playing?
Like he didn't seen it all. He's been coaching for buku years. He got a ton of Hall of Famers. So I feel like with that type of coach, like I don't feel like there's nothing wrong that he can tell me in life and football. Just he's like a father figure out there. He hold me to a high standard. And I just go out there, and when the plays come my way, I just want to make them for myself, my family, but also him, because he put me in position to make plays. So I love it. He's a great coach.
Thanks, Tavierre.
I appreciate it.